Hello and welcome. I'm Sean Fox. This is Made to Ramble, and we're in an airport. And it's far too late or early to pretend that I'm this cheerful. I'm happy to say we arrived safe and sound. And from leaving home to our arrival at the Airbnb here in Buenos Aires, it was about 25 hours. So it was a pretty exhausting trip over. Luckily, both of our flights were pretty comfortable. The flight from Perth to Auckland was really comfortable. We were supposed to have an emergency exit seat, but thanks to a bit of an error on Air New Zealand's part, our seats were changed and we ended up being upgraded to a sky couch. Sky couches are really cool. You always get three seats to two people, and you can raise the legs up to turn it into a kind of a mini bed. I mean, there's not a huge amount of room, but you're certainly able to stretch out a lot more than you would be able to normally. So this is the first time that either of us has crossed the international date line. There's something a little peculiar about arriving at your destination before you even left. I should also mention that we were pretty impressed with our new Carbo travel pillows. These little things make quite a difference on a long flight. You can hook these onto your seat headrest, which is pretty handy. And when you're not using it, you can roll it up and squeeze it into a nice compact ball thing, which just hangs off your backpack. We both found them really comfortable. You might have noticed that the graphic in the intro shows us traveling west, but that's only because the map wouldn't let me draw a path east. We were in fact traveling east from Perth, stopping briefly in New Zealand and then heading further east all the way to Buenos Aires. Anyway, here we are and it's time to head out and about and explore a little. We're staying in the Palermo district, and if our map is correct, it appears that there are a few points of interest within walking distance. So let's go check them out. Well, we're here at Eco Park, which seems to be some kind of old zoo. Nothing seems to be open, but there are some animals in there, but there's just these two little sections of park here at the moment. Eco Park is the Buenos Aires Zoo, and it's been closed down for a while now for renovations. The planetarium. Apparently, Buenos Aires is so vibrant that people are actually dancing in the street. Now, this appears to be some kind of free event, and not the only one of its kind we've seen today. Lula, con culo de mula, y no le tengas duda, ella le saca todo el jugo a la uva. Que hace vino, sí, hace vino. Yo la conocí en un taxi, en camino al club. Yo la conocí en un taxi, en camino al club. Behind me is Floralis Generica. It's a kind of a flower sculpture thing which actually opens at dawn and closes at dusk. I think the worst part of wandering around Buenos Aires is seeing all the dogs there. I mean, we love traveling, but we hate saying goodbye to our puppies. Okay, so walking distance might have been a bit of a stretch. We can barely stay upright now, and our blisters have blisters. So we might be taking it a little easier tomorrow. Anyway, our next video will take us to the slaughterhouse market, a spectacular cemetery, and the most beautiful bookstore in the world. So keep an eye out for that one. May take a little time for that video to come out, as I'm not likely to get it edited before we head off on our cruise to Antarctica, where the internet's sketchy to say the least. In the meantime, if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't done so already. Don't forget to ring that bell icon so you can be informed when the next video comes up. We'll be posting some blogs up on our travels on madetoramble.com, so keep an eye out for those. You can also check out some of our photos on Instagram and Flickr, and we'll see you again soon.